Welcome to the lecture series of signal system. In the previous lecture we have seen causal and non-causal systems. The one very important characteristics of the system is their linearity and non-linearity. So in this lecture we will come to know how we can test the linearity of a system, which is a very important characteristic of a system. So what is a linear and non-linear system? A system is said to be linear if it follows law of superposition, which consists of two laws, which is law of additivity and law of homogeneity. So what the law of additivity says, some textbook refers law of additivity as law of superposition. Some textbook says law of additivity is law of superposition. So law of additivity says that if there is a system S, if I am given an input x1t, this system produces output y1t. If I am giving x2t to this system, then it produces y2t. Then if I am giving summation of these two inputs to the same system S, means if I am giving x1t plus x2t as input to this system and it produces output as y1t plus y2t, then I can say that this system is going to follow the law of additivity. I will repeat again, there is a system S which produces output y1t when x1t given as input to the system, and if I am giving x2t to the system S, it produces output y2t, and if I am giving the summation of these two inputs x1t plus x2t as input to the system, then it produces y1t plus y2t. Here x1t and x2t are given independently to the system. Once x1t is applied, it produces y1t, then x2t is applied, it produces y2t, and when both the signals are combinedly provided as input to the system, then the system produces y1t plus y2t, then we can say that this system follows law of additivity. The second, here block diagram is represents here, that it is shown here in the block, through the block diagram. Once x1 is given to the system, it produces output y1t. x2 is given to the same system, then it produces output y2t, and we sum up these two outputs, which is y1t plus y2t, then we provide summation of these two inputs x1t plus x2t to the same input to the same system, and suppose it produces output y3t in this case. So if the output, there is a case 1, there is a case 2, if output in the second case is equal to the output in the first case, means if y3t is equal to y1t plus y2t, then we can say that this system is following law of additivity. Means if y3t here is equal to y1t plus y2t. Then we can say that this system is following the law of additivity. Here in the first case we sum up the output, we combining the input, and in the second case we are combining the input. And if the output in the both the cases are same, it means that the system is going to follow the law of additivity. Next, what we have to check is law of homogeneity. Law of homogeneity means if there is a system S, suppose there is a system S, we are giving input XT to this system and it produces output YT. And if this input is multiplied by a scalar or a constant, we can say, suppose this input XT is multiplied by a constant alpha, then and this input given to the same system and it is producing output alpha into YT, then we can say that this system follows law of homogeneity. I will repeat again, if XT is given to the system S, it produces output YT. In the second case, XT is multiplied by a constant alpha, then applied to the same system, and the system produces an output multiplied by same constant alpha. Then we can say that this system is going to follow law of homogeneity. We can use block diagram here. Suppose there is a system S and X1 is given to the system S, it produces output Y1T, and then this output is multiplied by a constant alpha, it produces alpha into Y1T. In the second case, input X1 is multiplied by alpha and applied to the system S, and it produces an output Y2T. If this Y2T is same as alpha into Y1T, if this output Y2 is equal to alpha into Y1T, then we can say that this system follows law of homogeneity, otherwise it is not a homogeneous system. That means if these two laws are followed by the system S, then strictly we can say that the given system is a linear system. So as a summary, I will repeat, if the system follows law of additivity and law of homogeneity, then the system is linear. In the law of homogeneity, to check the law of additivity, I will replace input X as X1T and Y as Y1T. Again, we will replace X by X2T and Y by Y2T. We will add up these two equations again. In place of XT, I will put X1T plus X2T. If in the outputs in both the cases are same, then we can say that the system follows law of additivity. To check the law of homogeneity, I will multiply with a constant alpha in the output. Then I will replace the input XT by alpha into XT, and if both the equations are same, then I will state that the given system is homogeneous also. And if the system follows these two laws, then we will write it as the system is a linear system, otherwise it is a non-linear system. System has to follow both the laws. If it follows law of homogeneity but not follows the law of additivity, or it follows law of additivity but not follows law of homogeneity, then the system is non-linear. Suppose I am going to check for homogeneity and system is not following law of homogeneity, then we do not have to check for law of additivity. system is already a non-linear system. Suppose I am going to check for law of additivity, it is not follows law of additivity, then we does not have to check for law of homogeneity, it is already a non-linear system. So both the conditions are necessary to follow linearity by a system. Some examples are there, like here. Yes, it is given here that if alpha 1 x1 t is given to the system, alpha 2 x2 t is given to the system, then its output should be alpha 1 into y1 t plus alpha 2 into y2 t. We can write alpha 1 into y1 t and alpha 2 into y2 t is equal to transformation of alpha 1 x1 t plus alpha 2 x2 t here. We can also break this equation as y1 t can be written as alpha 1 transfer of x1 t, alpha 2 transfer of x2 t is equal to transfer of alpha 1 x1 t plus alpha 2 x2 t. So, and for discrete systems, the same equation can be written like this. Some important examples are there. We have to check here the in the given examples, we have to check for the linearity of the system. Go through these two examples very carefully, because linearity and non-linearity of a system is very much important to study an LTI system. So go through these examples very carefully. The first example says that yt, the output of the system is equal to x of t square. If output yt is equal to x of t square, then what is, look into the procedure how to check, how to test a linear system, how to check a system is linear or not. Suppose yt is given as x of t square. To check law of additivity, first what I said that replace x by x1 and y by y1, then y1 t will be equal to x1 t square and y2 t will be equal to x2 t square. Then y1 t plus y2 t will be equal to x1 t square plus x2 t square. Remember this equation, y1 t plus y2 t is equal to x1 into t square plus x2 t square. This is step 1. Then in the next step, replace the input by x1 t plus x2 t. Suppose there is an input, suppose there is an input x dash t is equal to x1 t plus x2 t. Then replace x t by x dash t in the equation. Suppose the output is y3 t, in that case, then y3 t will be equal to y3 t will be equal to x dash t square, which is equal to x1 t square plus x2 t square. If this y3 t, if this y3 t is equal to y1 t plus y2 t, then the given system follows law of additivity. What was the output? I said, remember the data, the y1 t plus y2 t was giving the same output as x1 t square plus x2 t square. Here y3 t is also giving the same result, x1 t square plus x2 t square. That means the given system follows the law of additivity. In the next, I will multiply by a constant alpha in the yt, then alpha into yt will become alpha into x t square. Then I will replace the input by alpha into x t, then it will become y2. Suppose the output in this case is y2t, then y2t is equal to alpha into xt square. In both the cases output is same. It means that y2t is equal to alpha into yt. It means that the given system follows the law of homogeneity also. It means that the given system is a linear system. Now move to the second example, which is given here as yt is equal to, it is given here as yt is equal to 2x square t, 2x square of t. Repeat the process again. First check the law of additivity, which says that I will replace the variable x by x1 and y by y1, then it will become y1t is equal to t x1 square, sorry, t x1 square t, and it is not t, it is 2, sorry, y1t is equal to 2 times x1 square t, y2t is equal to 2 times x2 square t, then y1t plus y2t will be equal to y1t plus y2t is equal to 2 times x1 square plus 2 times x1 square plus x2 square. Instead of x1t and x2t, I will write it as x1 and x2 only to save the space. So y1t plus y2t is equal to 2 times x1 square plus x2 square. Now remember this result. Remember this result, that y1t plus y2t is equal to 2 times x1 square plus x2 square. In the next case, I will assume another variable as x dash t is equal to x1 plus x2, x1t plus x2t. So if this input is applied to this output, it will result as yt is equal to 2 times x dash square t, and x dash t is equal to, I can write it as 2 times x dash t square. I will write it as 2 times x dash t square, and in place of x dash t, I will write x1 plus x2. So it will be equal to 2 times x1 plus x2 whole square. In the previous case, the result was y1t, suppose here it is y3t. In the previous case, y1t plus y2t plus y2t was equal to 2 times x1 square plus x2 square. Are these results same? This and this, they are same or not? Here it is x1 plus x2 whole square. Here it is x1 square plus x2 square. They are not the same. They are different results. That's why we can say that the given system will not follow the law of additivity. And if system does not follow the law of additivity, I will directly say that the system is a non-linear system. We does not have to check this system for law of homogeneity. Again, the third example is yt is equal to e power xt. In the same way, I will write y1t is equal to e power x1t and y2t is equal to e power x2t and y1 plus y2 will be equal to e power x1 plus e power x2. Remember this result. y1 plus y2 will be equal to e power x1 plus e power x2. Again, replace the variable x by x1 plus x2. Then I will write it as y3t is equal to e power x1 plus x2. E power x1 plus x2. The previous result was y1 plus y2 was equal to e power x1 plus e power x2. It means that these two results are not same. They are not same. This is e power x1 plus x2. This is e power x1 plus e power x2. It means that the given system does not follow law of additivity. So the given system is a non-linear system. We does not have to go for the testing of homogeneity of this system. It is a non-linear system. Next example is d2yt by dt square plus 2tyt is equal to t square xt. In the same way, we can check the additivity of this system as d square y1ty dt square y1ty dt square plus 2t y1t plus 2t y1t is equal to t square x1t. Again, I will write d square y2y dt square plus 2t y2t is equal to t square x2t. Add up these two equations, we will get d2 square by dt square into y1 plus y2 plus 2t y1 plus y2 is equal to t square x1 plus x2. d2 by dt square by into y1 plus y2 plus 2t y1 plus y2 plus is equal to t square x1 plus x2. In the next, I will replace x by x1 plus x2. After replacing x by x1 plus x2, I will find the right side as x1 plus x2 here. I will replace x by x1 plus x2. The result will be same. Suppose here, if I will replace x by x1 plus x2, then the equation will become d2 yt by dt square plus 2t y1t is equal to t square x1 plus x2. Here, the right side in this equation also is same as in this equation. Remaining things are simple. y1 plus y2, y1 plus it is equal to x1 plus x2. It means that the given system follows the law of additivity. to check the law of homogeneity, I will replace yt by alpha yt, then I will get d2 alpha yt by dt square plus 2t 2 alpha t yt is equal to t square alpha xt. In the same equation, I will replace this xt by alpha xt only. So, I will get d2yt by, suppose this is y dash t, by dt square plus 2 alpha t y dash t is equal to t square alpha xt. In both the cases, result is same here. It is t square alpha xt. Here also, the input is t square alpha xt. It means that the given system follows the law of homogeneity also. Hence, the given system is a linear system. Again, the next example is, it is 2 dy by dt plus 5 yt is equal to x square t. There is a clue here that the given term is x square t. So, when I will replace x by x1 and x by x2 and add up them, it will give x1 square plus x2 square. And when I will replace x by x1 plus x2, it will give x1 plus x2 whole square. These two results are not same. Hence, the given system will not follow the law of additivity. The given system is a non-linear system. Here, because these two terms are multiplied, it will give non-linearity also. I will we can check it as, once replace x by x1 and y by y1, we will get dy1 by dt plus y1t will give x1 dx1 by dt, x1 into dx1 by dt, and again dy2 by dt plus y2t is equal to x2 dx2 by dt. On adding them we will get d of y1 plus y2 by dt plus y1 plus y2 is equal to x1 plus x2 into d of x1 plus x2 by dt. The equation is d of y1 plus y2 by dt plus y1 plus y2 is equal to x1 plus x2 into dx1 by dx2, d of x1 plus x2 by dt. Again, if I will replace this variable by x1 plus x2, the equation will become dy3 by dt plus y3 is equal to x1 plus x2 into x1 plus x2 into d of x1 plus x2 by dt. Here simply x is replaced by x1 plus x2. Both the equations are same. In the previous equation, it was written here y1 plus y2, here written y1 plus y2. The given equation is same, and as the given equation is same as the previous equation, it means that the given system will follow law of additivity. But When we will test for law of homogeneity, I will replace, I will multiply the whole equation by alpha. Then we will get d alpha into dy by dt plus alpha y is equal to alpha x dx by dt. But when we will replace x by alpha into x, we will get dy2 by dt plus y2 is equal to alpha square here into x into dx by dt, because both the x, here is the x, here is the x, both will be replaced by alpha, it will produce alpha square. It means that the given system does not follow law of homogeneity, that's why the given system is a non-linear system. Last one is, I will replace y1t is equal to integration minus infinite to t x1 tau d tau, and y2t is equal to minus infinite to t x2 tau d tau. Sum of them, we will get y1 plus y2 will be equal to minus infinite to t x1 plus x2, x1 plus x2 into d tau. In the next case, replace the variable x by x1 plus x2, we will get y3t is equal to minus infinite to t x1 plus x2 d tau. Here y3t is same as y1t plus y2t. It means that the given system follows law of additivity. Again, if I have to check the law of homogeneity, I will multiply the whole equation by alpha. Then this alpha into yt is equal to alpha into minus infinite to t x tau d tau. In the next step, I will replace this variable x tau by alpha into x tau only. Then we will get, suppose here output is a y dash t, then it is equal to minus alpha to t alpha times x tau d tau. Both the equations are same, means alpha yt is equal to y dash t. It means that the given system follows the law of homogeneity also. Because this system follows both laws, it means that the given system is a linear system. So in the given systems, I will highlight the systems which are linear. This is a linear system. Again, this is a linear system. These two systems are non-linear. Why? Because here is a term x square, which makes this system non-linear. The x square violates the law of additivity. Here, there is a multiplication of inputs. That's why this will violate the law of homogeneity. These two systems are non-linear, but this system is a linear system. So there are many methods to check for the linearity of the system. You can apply both the laws simultaneously. We can write the input as alpha x1 plus alpha x2. If this input produces an output, weighted output alpha y1 plus alpha into y2, then directly we can speak that the given system is a linear system. So if there is a weighted input produces weighted output, then we can say that the given system is a linear system. So there is another method to check for linearity of the system. This is all for this lecture, and thanks for listening.